And all these super heavy elements from 114 to 180, these are synthesized using the 48 calcium as a beam and the actinide target at 2. And right now, these are the super heavy elements which are basically synthesized experimentally at Dumna JINR. With this element number Z is equal to 114, E is equal to 285 to 289, 115 from 287 to 290, and 116 from 290 to 293, 170 recently, 293 up to 294, and 118, this one, 294. These are the super heavy elements basically which are synthesized using the 48 calcium beam and the actinide target. And for the 119 and 120, the plan is going on. But they are now using different type of incident type instead of 48 calcium. Now the question is about the stability of these super heavy elements. If suppose we synthesize these super heavy elements, so which one will be the magic number? That will be spherical or that will be uniform. But mostly, macromicroscopic theories and other theories predict these super heavy elements number for the stability of super heavy elements 114 and 184, or 120, 184, or 126, 184, and some theory also, microscopic theory also suggested N is equal to 172 volts. So this is the idea of these super heavy elements, that how to synthesize them, and what the main question is about the stability of these super heavy elements, and what will be the next magic number. And this 108, 162, N is equal to 162. This is where the alpha particle as well as the heavy cluster were assumed to be preborn in the parent nucleus before they could penetrate the potential barrier with the Q2. And the preformation probabilities of the different size of the clusters are different, is calculated. And this PCM model is basically based on the quantum mechanical fragmentation theory of Marun and Brenner. So here are some collective or basically parameters on which this theory is based and successfully explain the fission, fusion, cluster irregularity and other parts of this theory. So for that, this relative separation on collective coordinate between the center of masses of the two nuclei, the orbition parameter beta 1 and beta 2 define the semi major axis and minor axis, and two dynamical collective coordinates of the mass and charge asymmetry parameter eta, that is defined by this way, eta z z1 minus z2, where limiting value of the eta is 0, that shows the symmetric fission, and eta is equal to 1, that indicates complete fusion. So this is one of the part, and to find the basically a preform of the new fragments is defined by this way in the preform cluster model space. I have to talk about the two models. One is the PCM and second one is the modified, that is ICM, isospin cluster model. So I have to mention basically that radius which was used into the preformed cluster model. And for the nuclear potential, this proximity potential is used. There are all these from SIBA, Sussman Central Redi, the nuclear surface tension, and the universal function constant is used. And the rotational energy that is as such, there is no contribution into the alpha decay and cluster decay multiplication, but is defined by this field. So how I calculated this half life in Kirchhoff, and by this way, by the scattering potential, this penetration probability is calculated. This is the touching configuration, and this one is the outer motion. So through the PI and PV, this penetration probability is calculated. And now the super heavy elements, and this is the result of the fragmentation potential. In case of 296 and 160, how this fragmentation potential is useful to calculate the excitation energy of the compound? Not only to the excitation energy, but for the projectile and target combination also, using these cold reactions values according to the model. So this is the fragmentation potential, and this one is the correspond to the ground state. If I measure this minima here, this is correspond to 30 mega electron volt, this one is 10 mega electron volt, this one is correspond to 40 mega electron volt. These are the results correspond to the cold fusion reactions, warp and tapping, and hot fusion reactions. And similarly for this 292-140 nucleus also. So by using these cold reaction values, one can find out the excitation energy of the compound nucleus and the projectile and target combinations for these super heavy elements. So by this way, this fragmentation potential is important, at least for me. And this is the fragment mass distribution field, where this one very symmetric projectile and target combinations, these one are the nearly symmetric, and this one asymmetric projectile target combination. So we talk about the symmetric or asymmetric projectile and target combinations. Now the alpha decay processing set, super life indicate the stability of the parent against the peak, right? And the alpha decay, now everyone knows that alpha decay half life is sensitive to the Q value. So I keep these two concepts in my mind for the calculation, and especially for the nuclear structure, and that comes through the magic number or stability. So this one is the 292-160 nucleus, and this calculation is made under the preform cluster model right now. And compared with the other theoretical model and experimental calculations. So open circle for the PCM calculations, where theoretical binding energy used from the molar mix table, and some experimental jo binding energy hai from the OD Warusta table, and that time it was from the 2003 table. So half life is plotted as a function of the parent mass number. This one. So this is the open circle is for the PCM calculation, and this closed circle dot for the experimental result, and the triangular for the theoretical calculation. And similarly for the 288-140 nucleus. So you can see the result of PCM calculation and other experimental result and other theoretical model. Right now there is only one theoretical calculation of the Royer model, and there is so much difference.
So, what is the inference then?
My purpose of this talk is, as I have said, that there are two models, one is PCM, and little bit I have modified this PCM model. So I am just trying to show that the difference between the half-life earlier, in earlier case, in 2003, this one. And right now there is only one theoretical model, and obviously the experiment.
So after
model
time, you
have to improve. Yeah. As Professor Russ said to you, sir, that if you use radius, I have used in that model radius isospin dependent radius of Meyer-Swett P. And then because of that, proximity potential modified, and because of that further the half-life, basically the result of the half-life was improved 2 to 4 order. That was the point. If this was the question where you asked, yeah. Sir,
how sensitive?
How sensitive that are basically. In cluster decay, this is more important because every time the isospin is changing. So I have used isospin radius of my Meyer-Swett paper, and because of that, I have to modify it.
But this radius is the radius of the nucleus obtained. I mean, how the compare with the electron spectrum data?
Earlier one.
Both. Huh. Earlier one was compatible, and this one is becoming different.
ये भरत एक मिनट का ठीक है अच्छा ठीक ओ थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू दिस इज अबाउट द सेंसिटिविटी ऑफ द क्यूबॉइड इफ यू सी हियर कैलकुलेटेड क्यू वैल्यू इज 10.696 एंड एक्सपेरिमेंटल वैल्यू इज 10.310 can see the result of half-life. This is 0.406, 1.07. 7.726 is the result of calculated Q value. And this is 7.46, and you can see the result here. So this is the idea of sensitivity about the Q value.
How you calculate Q value?
Q value from the Molarnik's table and the experimental binding. Master. Because of you, this is again, I have calculated the half-life for the 115 paper. Z is equal to 115, 27, n is 288. So these are the half-life, basically logarithmic half-life, which floated with respect to the atomic charge number. And as I said earlier, that for the nuclear structure information, if half-life, parent half-life is maximum, that we provide the information about the parent, and the half-life basic meaning that we provide the information about the total of the parent. So in this decay chain, 287 and 288, here this particular 283, Z is equal to, Z is equal to 115, N is equal to 70. So this, because the half-life is maximum, is because of the 172 or this nearby to that. And here, because of this 165, N is equal to 165, and this 107, that was near probably the bomb closer. Yes, sir. Only 5 minutes. Then I come to my teacher. These are results, but for the isospin cluster model, that is more important for the. So systematically, what I did for this these nuclei 287 and 288 here, I have used other model also for the comparison in the next calculation to check, and now I have used different Q values also, experimental from the Myers and Mountain also, to see the effect further and to modify the result in this way that time. But the result almost same. This is the calculations are for 291-120 and 303-120. Here half life is maximum for this particular nucleus that indicate basically that is equal to 112 and n is equal to 163 like this one. So this is the experimental result. And this study was just to check the magicity in super heavy mass emission and further. Here correspond z is equal to 114 and is equal to 117 for this 297-120 alpha decay chain. And here the life is minimum for this total, that is 108 and 165. Further for 326 and 128 and 320-128, the half-life for this particular parent was 124 and 194. The interest is only for just to check the magnetic cell. And the minima was for the daughter 114 and 184. And for this was 116 and
184.
Now in this particular paper, what I did as I said that I have modified the radius. And because of that the proximity potential was improved as a result. And further I have used Bethe-Lisker mass formula of Samantha and other Q values also from other model also and experimental Q values. So here I have shown that this star experimental result. This calculation is for PCM model which I have discussed right now. And this open circle is for the ICM calculation where I am saying that I have used the isospin dependent radius. So now this one is the PCM calculation and this open circle was the isospin cluster model calculation. Improved basically version of the PCM. And you can compare here the result as compared to the earlier case. So this calculation was made for the 293-117 and 294-117.
How much change in the radius? Then again, what was it?
Exactly, no. I don't know how much. I am seeing that. And this is the result of that calculation. I have marked here the Bethe-Lisker formula and the Q value of that. And the result that is near about to the experimental calculation. For 289-115 it was minus 0.149 and the experimental result. So I can say that this model basically by using that proximity isospin dependent radius improved the preformed cluster model. Same part. And now if you will allow me then I will speak. If you don't allow me then I have to skip this part. It depends on you. But by this calculation, I just calculate that nuclear structure information for the stability of the magic number which are predicted by other model also. And in addition to that, I have extended this model as Professor Manoj Wasserman described about the Poynaro that lacked radioactivity and I found this result very well at the time in the 2011 when Poynaro predicted about this radioactivity. At the same time, I found that this result is very good according to this calculation also. And in SN radioactivity, I found basically the new cell closure that was around 66. That's why sir, I have asked to do a link more. In addition to this 50 and 82, I found the new cell closure with the same calculation.
This summary. 10116 is deformed or what?
Obviously, it will
be. So, this is deformed method?
10116. N is equal to 66. 66.
But then it's 15 magic.
50 is magic, but 4 is the neutron number. This is the summary to apply this way. I see that n is equal to 172 is the most probable magic dot slow cell closure. For this calculation, 10 variable protein transfer is the most probable magic dot. N is equal to 66 at the end. Thank you.
Okay, we have time for questions. Mr. Sahu.
Can you please tell us a little bit more about the exact layout of the cube? Cube, getting a potential, you are calculating the cube unit. And what makes you sure that this is a cube unit? Can you any physical properties that will assert
and everything depends on the cube value? So the binding energy and other parts.
Yes, it depends on the cube value. That is separate thing. I mean, how do you calculate the cube value?
How you did calculate in your calculation?
I want to
know.
I calculate. I don't mass model. If this is the question, I have just
because you saw the proximity potential. From the potential, you have calculated the cube value. As Patra will also tell you.
No. Cube value is calculating for the mass models.
From the molar mix
and other part it is sensitive to Q value. Means Q might be changing.
Different model are calculating the Q value. Right? Some are also calculating. I am using that.
So let us go to the other point.
That's why this time I have used 6-7 Q values.
So is there any other questions?
I don't think so.
So now we are done this and breakfast tea. And we meet at 4 o'clock.
Okay, very good.
Like clever of us with the thing.